So Megs, I have to say, you look absolutely stunning and Rob is a very, very lucky man. You literally brought tears to my eyes today when I saw you in your dress. Absolutely gorgeous. And you are now, and always have been, the most wonderful daughter that anyone could ever wish to have. And I'm so proud to be your dad, and I mean that.
My dearest Robbie, I knew you as my soulmate from the very first day I met you. On our first date, I knew I'd met my future husband, and here we are today getting married, and I was right, as always. There are so many things I love about you. I love your kindness, compassion, and selflessness. I love how deeply you feel. I love it when you laugh so much you cry. I love the way you love me, and in doing so, taught me to love myself. And I even love it when you talk about maths and Excel spreadsheets with a passion that I cannot understand. You have given me so many things to be thankful for. Thankful that you don't just love my best parts, but also the bits I'm still working on. Thankful that you've held my hand while we explore the most magical places on our travels. Thankful that we have both grown and blossomed together.
So Rob, I'd like to officially welcome you to the family. Although you have been a big part of it for a long time now, I'd say that you're almost part of the furniture. Although I think the furniture probably moves a little bit faster than you. No, but not only is Rob a big part of the family, I also think of him as a good friend too. Okay.
Meg, what an adventure our lives have become. An adventure that is as unexpected as it is beautiful. In you, I found my best friend, my life partner, and my one true love. Of all the people you've met on your journey and all the distance between us, you've somehow and some way ended up here with me. I used to think I was lucky to have met you all those years ago in a place very special to our hearts. But now I know without a doubt that the universe put you in front of me because we were meant to be together. You have filled my life with joy and given me a sense of peace that I've never known. You're my biggest supporter through every personal challenge. I have learned to be happy and accept myself all because you have accepted me as I am. I can't wait to continue to explore the world together.
Right, let's talk about Meg, the beautiful Meg. Right, from an early age, Meg loved anything to do with art. Her auntie Lisa would always help Sarah when the children were young. They would sit for hours colouring whilst watching Disney videos. One of her favourites was Beauty and the Beast. I guess you could say Meg has now found her beast. Meg has so many wonderful qualities. Not only is she beautiful on the outside, but also on the inside. She's funny, charming, kind, and always thinking of others first. She's a true inspiration to us all. I'm sure you all agree.
I'm so grateful that you have shown me that home can be a person, not just a place. You've shown me that true love, like the movies, is real. Thank you for making me feel safe and loved in every minute. So here are my promises to you. I promise to cheer you on through all your successes. I promise to lift you up when you're feeling down and to hold your hand through the hard times. I promise to always support you and encourage you to be the best version of yourself. I promise to always make you feel loved and safe as you do with me, and I promise to appreciate every little moment with you and to love you forever. Our love story is truly magical. I couldn't be happier to marrying my best friend, my love, my everything. I love you.
Flower.
Although today marks the start of the rest of our lives, I know it will not be enough time with you. Time is precious. I will not take our time for granted. And because words cannot do it, I promise to show you for the rest of our lives how much I love and care for you. I promise to encourage you to follow your dreams every day. I promise to be there for you through the bad and the good. I promise to face everything as equals and as one. I promise to be loyal and faithful to you before all else. I promise when we are old and grey, we will look back on our past with no regrets. I promise to listen and learn from you, to trust and appreciate you. I promise to love you with all my heart, and I promise from this day forward, you'll never be on your own.
A best man speech is traditionally about sharing some embarrassing stories of the groom. I've known Bob for 14 years and I haven't managed to gather much dirt on him. He's definitely the mature one out of the pair of us. A few years ago, Bob turned to me and he said, "Every night before bed, I have a yogurt just to calm me down." I thought, a yogurt to calm you down? What? I just didn't understand it, but he's fooling you all. Have you ever seen him without his yogurt in the evening? Next page. I think we can all agree that our bride, well, Rob's bride, looks absolutely beautiful. Well, as for Bob, you can't polish a turd, but you can put it in a nice three-piece suit. Bob, you look lovely as well, Bob, don't worry. Right, this might not land, but an emotional day, no, a wedding is an emotional day for everyone. Even the cake is in tears. If we had a cake, it would be in tears. More so for me and Wayne. We are very moved.
You have done it last night, yeah?
How can I describe Rob? Well, he's very, very tall, he's kind, he's handsome, he's tall, he's hardworking, charming, and did I mention tall? Yeah. No, he's not so good at golf. Now, Rob, you are an amazing guy, and you obviously have a special love for Meg, along with a love for spreadsheets. I'm not joking, everything is displayed on a spreadsheet. So, Rob, I have devised my own spreadsheet as a guide to a happy marriage.
Despite how perfect Bob is and how kind Bob is, we've still fallen out a fair few times over the years. Well, not a fair few times, a couple of times. And one of the times was actually when he first got with Meg. He just got out of a relationship that I don't think he was overly happy in. And I was looking forward to being able to smash Bob whenever I wanted. On the tennis, we play tennis. Why is everyone looking at me now? I've got a girlfriend right there.
In the name of the law, I declare you man and wife.
And now, the groom may kiss the bride.
This will be an everlasting love. This will be.
In all seriousness, though, Bob is probably the kindest person I've ever met. I know for a fact that he would do anything for me or for any of you guys here today at all. He gives such good advice, and believe me, I've needed it a few times over the years. He's the most selfless person I know. If anyone deserves happiness, it's him. And that's just for listening to my waffle for hours on end. If there's any... Whoa, are you interrupting?
So before I get into the thank yous, I just wanted to say, doesn't Meg look absolutely stunning? I honestly feel like I've won the lottery, and I don't just mean a £2 scratch card. I mean the actual thing. Now, I speak for both of us when I say we've had an amazing day so far and looking forward to the evening. We feel very lucky to have our closest friends and family here, so we thank you all for coming. I know you've all had a bit of a journey to get here, so we really do appreciate it. As I'm sure you realise, it took a lot of effort from various people here to make this happen. For instance, without me getting down on one knee proposing to Meg, none of this would have been possible. So I think you should thank me, but then also thank Meg for saying yes.
Overall, I think Bob is a great example to anyone, especially me. He works so hard at everything, and I can see here today he has everything he's ever wished for with you, Meg. If people were to view me as half the man that Rob is, I would be very happy with that. I'd like to wish them a very happy time on their honeymoon. That's what it's called, a honeymoon. Honeymoon, next week, in Wales. Well, I presume they're going to Wales, because Bob said he's going to Bangor all week.
Whatever your relationship with Meg, you know that she is a kind, caring and compassionate she is. You have made me feel more comfortable and at home, and I am proud to call you my family, so I'd raise a glass to you two. By the way, with all this talk of Meg being the super confident one, I just want to make it clear that I'm still the one that wears the trousers in the relationship. Every other Wednesday for an hour and twice on my birthday. In all seriousness, I feel blessed to be able to call you my wife. You never fail to make me smile. You always bring out the best of me. You're patient, caring, selfless, and one day, maybe today, I hope you agree with me when I say you're an amazing person. You are more than just my wife, you're my best friend, and I want to thank you for agreeing to make me the happiest man in the world and allowing me to play golf on one. I look forward to many, many happy years I know we'll have together, and I cannot wait to begin our married life together at home.
Now, Meg and Rob have so much in common, they are fiercely loyal and have so much love and support for each other that I, for one, think they are the perfect match. And I believe Tinder thought so too. Thank God for Tinder. After all, with their height difference, I really don't think their eyes would meet across a crowded room, do you? So my only words of advice to you both are, always be yourselves, because you are both perfect just the way you are. So, could we all please raise our glasses to the newly married couple? May your journey through life be filled with love and happiness. To Meg and Rob.
To Meg and Rob.
Love you both.
And finally, I wanted to mention that I'm thinking about the people who are no longer with us today. My granddad Reg, beloved great-grandma, and also Rob's granddads Godfrey and Ron. We're also missing the lovely Brian, who's unfortunately couldn't travel today, but he's normally always by my nana's side. Brian's watched me grow up and always been present. We will make sure to celebrate with him when we're home. I could go on and on about how much you all mean to me. There are people here today that have known me as long as I've known myself. People that have grown up, we've grown up with, and also people that have come into our lives more recently. But there's one thing you all have in common, and that's that we love you, we appreciate you, and we're so grateful for you.
When I say Waltie, you say woo woo.
Waltie!
Waltie!